And we welcome you to Millett Hall here on the campus of Miami University on this Friday night. It is the Miami RedHawks women's basketball team continuing their homestand tonight with the Colonels from Eastern Kentucky and the Atlantic Sun Conference. When Jack Schmelzinger and Patrick Geshan, appreciate you spending a part of your Friday evening with us. An Eastern Kentucky team that comes in 4-3 overall. Miami team 2-4 overall in the season. The Colonels coming off a loss at Tennessee on Sunday. 105-71 was the score against the Volunteers for the Colonels. The RedHawks coming off Deanna Hendricks' 150th career win. That was on Monday inside this building. A 79-53 win against Loyola Chicago. And so, Jack, two teams that are kind of in similar spots as you look at the overall big picture, and it's going to be a pretty good one on paper so far tonight.
Yeah, Patrick, it really does seem like a pretty good matchup here between the Colonels and the RedHawks. Both teams took pretty close losses at Evansville earlier this year. For the RedHawks, I think really the most important thing is going to be hitting their shots. Yeah. In every game so far this year where they've shot above 45% from the field, they've taken the win. So, got to guess if they can do that again, probably have a good shot.
That's probably a good point. One of the storylines for the RedHawks, of course, Payne Scott, 15 minutes in her last two appearances on the season. They're just trying to get her back to normal after the injury. We'll see how long she goes tonight. The 15 minutes, of course, that was on the floor for her on Monday against Loyola Chicago, where she put up a season-high 13 points. 39 points away from 1,500 in her career coming in. So the big storyline for the RedHawks fans, how much is she going to play and what state is she in her injury sort of adventure right now?
Yeah, Patrick, and it's, 13 points in 15 minutes, that's really impressive. Yeah. For the RedHawks, really the bona fide star of this team. She's been great. For 4 years, she was named second team All-MAC last year, and she has a huge brace on her right knee now. Just looking at her, it doesn't even, I don't remember seeing someone play basketball wearing a knee brace that large before, but she's out right there moving around really well, so it will be very interesting to see if she can follow that up here against the Colonels.
Eastern Kentucky team led by Antoinette Walker. She's averaging 20 points per game this season. The Marquette transfer going to be someone to watch for the RedHawks defensively so far tonight.
Yeah, she's averaging a double-double this year so far too. She's been really, really good. 47.3% from the field as well. And I'm pretty interested to see how Alice Ricanti does. She's shooting nearly 40% from three, so a real sharpshooter out on the outside of that court for the Colonels. It'll be interesting to see how they make that offense work tonight.
Colonels have won four of their last six games. They finished third in the Atlantic Sun West Division last season under their second-year head coach, Greg Todd. This is their second true road game of the year. They're 0-1 away from home this season. The RedHawks come in 2-1 at home. They've lost three of their past four games. Starting lineups will occur now inside Millett Hall. Let's listen in to the public address.
Danielle Rainey. At forward number 13, Mary Walker. At forward number 20, Emma Hacker. At guard number 30, Alicia Reckonoden. And at forward number 53, Bridget Fox. The assistant coaches are Veronica Ryan, Corinna Brown, Abby Owens. The head coach for Eastern Kentucky is Greg Todd. Forward from Minneapolis, Minnesota, number two, CDI Sierra Moro. A 5A star from Minster, Ohio. Number 4, Ivy Wolf. A 5A star from Lynchburg, Ohio. Number 24, Dan Scott. And a 6-2 forward from Avon, Indiana. Number 34, Amani Freeman. Director of Basketball Operations, Megan Felke. The assistant coaches for Miami are Tiffany Swafford.
All right, so there you are, your starting 5-4 Miami tonight. Maddie Kloos, you got Sierra Morrow, Ivy Wolf, Peyton Scott, Amani Freeman will start. Scott does start tonight. It's a really good sign for Miami fans.
Yeah, it is. That's right. Her first start of the season. Will be interesting to see, like you said just a few minutes ago, how many minutes she's actually out there on the floor. And this Miami team has had a lot of trouble shooting the ball so far this season, so they could really benefit from having Scott out there driving that offense for an extended period tonight.
Seriously. Pretty average crowd for a game here inside Millett Hall. It's really light when we arrived about an hour ago, but people have filled in nicely right before the tip-off here to Oxford. Okay student crowd as well. Eastern Kentucky is in maroon uniform tonight. Eastern Kentucky across the front in white with a white number on the front of the uniform as well. There's a white number on the back. RedHawks in their home whites. Miami across the front in red with a red number on the front and a red number on the back as well. For Miami, who will move right to left across your radio in quarter number one. There's this RedHawks team trying to extend the home record this season to 3-1 on the year. Mentioned they've lost three of their past four games and a stretch now of 4 of 5 games at home. This is game two of that stretch. Opening tip-off thrown up, RedHawks win it. Sierra Morrow back to Ivy Wolf. The game is on from Millett Hall. RedHawks with the ball to start to our left on offense. Far side outside the arc, Maddie Kloos goes top of the key for Ivy Wolf. And just dribbles with a right arm up top. 15 to shoot to the near wing. They go for a pass to Sydney Watkins. Now near wing, it is Scott from the left elbow with a shot that's good. Payne Scott gets on the board first with a jumper there from 10 feet away. 2-0 RedHawk lead 30 seconds in. The Colonels try to feed down low. It was Daniel Rainey going to Emma Hacker. Could not connect and went off a RedHawk hand out of bounds to the baseline at Eastern Kentucky will inbound here. Thrown out top of the key on the inbound feed. Hacker long three, that's too strong. RedHawks crash for the rebound far corner but stolen away by Walker. Goes back up top of the key, a feed there. They get picked off by Wolf. Far wing now, Scott driving to the basket and she will get it in for an and one. Off the window for two with both arms for Scott on a great feed from Wolf cross court to the right wing and Scott will go to the line for a chance at a 3-point play in a 4-0 game with 9:16 to go in the first.
Patrick, it was such a beautiful pull-up jumper in that first RedHawk possession. You know that when Peyton Scott's getting to that shot, it's going to go in. Good to see her get to it so quickly and now has her chance to score a 5th point with just less than a minute even gone in this game.
First free throw is good for Scott. The only free throw she has all 5 RedHawk points in the game tonight, 50 seconds in.
Poke that ball loose too.
For sure. So it's Alice Racanani top the key for Eastern Kentucky, the far wing for Walker. Antoinette Walker, pull-up jumper just beyond the free throw line. It's good for 2. The Colonels find the board. Make it 5-2 RedHawks, 8:54 to go in the first.
Patrick, if we get to watch Walker and Scott go back and forth all night, I think this is going to be a pretty fun one here for Millett.
Me too. Walker averaging 20 points per game on the season, 10.6 rebounds. Far wing with it, RedHawks work wide open 3 on the right side. It was Wolf too much on it. They tipped the rebound out of bounds. Goes off the Colonels, Daniel Rainey, who got tied up with Freeman under the hoop. The RedHawks hold on to the possession here, far side of their offensive baseline. 20 to shoot, 8:38 to go in the first. Far side with it, Scott flips it into the right elbow with the ball. Freeman to the far wing. Scott, 3 was tipped there, but she got it back. Scott tried to the rack, and it's good for 2 on a quick feed over on the near side of the post. Morrow finished off for the RedHawks. Scott with a huge assist there. Miami up 7-2. Walker with it, right point. We'll try to fling this one off the window too much. And she drove her way to the rack. RedHawks working up the left wing over the timeline as Scott gets it top of the key. Up there is Morrow, dishes back for Wolf. Left-handed dribble, near wing outside the arc. Scott flips it down to the baseline. Freeman, left side of the paint, trying to work here. Guarded heavily by Bridget Fox of Eastern Kentucky. goes back outside the arc, left wing with Ivy Wolf, six to shoot. Wolf bounce pass, left side of the paint, Freeman shovels right wing. Scott, three ball off, too much with one to shoot. Rebound picked up by the Colonels. And Emma Hacker, there your partner, is racking at you over the timeline on the right wing. Left wing, she'll pass it, three there, short. Off the mark by Rainey, back in the hands of the Colonels. Rainey with it on the offensive rebound. She'll try another three from the left wing, too much on that. Rebound picked up by Clouse on the timeline, left wing for the RedHawks. Patty Clouse, left elbow with the ball, bounces it top of the key to Morrow, back up top for Ivy Wolf near half court. Left wing feed outside the arc for Clouse, 15 to shoot for the RedHawks. Clouse with a right-handed dribble, goes top of the key for Ivy Wolf, drives down the right side of the paint, whistle for a foul as she was trying to go to the rack, and it looks like an inbound coming here for the RedHawks. 7-8 to go in the first, and Miami up 7-2.
Her first, the team's second.
Offensive end inbound for the baseline for the RedHawks. Wolf will send it in on a bounce to Freeman. Went off a leg out of bounds. It was Freeman's leg, and this one going back to the Colonels as it dribbled off there to the baseline. So Eastern Kentucky inbounds. Hacker will go to Reconati. Over the timeline, middle of the floor. Wolf is with her, bounce pass near wing. With it is Rainey. Gets it to Walker, right elbow. Left wing three, Racanati, too much on it. And the rebound is an offensive one for Fox, who got fouled by Sierra Morrow, applied too much contact, also going after the ball. Fox locked it up. Morrow gave her a little shove to the right side of the body, and a first foul of the game goes against the RedHawks with 6:48 to go in the first.
A little bit of a sloppy start here tonight, Patrick. A couple of kind of not the greatest shot selection from Eastern Kentucky on a couple of their possessions so far, and then a little sloppy boxing out there for the RedHawks.
Right. Hasn't been clean at all. Eastern Kentucky with the ball here in the paint. Walker up and under, move is good with the left arm off the window for two, driving across the post. And it's 7-4 RedHawks, 6.5 to go in the first quarter. Wolf for the ball right wing, outside the arc for the RedHawks. Near side, Clouse gets the feed to Morrow through the paint from near side to far side, and she's fouled. Eastern Kentucky arm got in there. Looks like Bridget Fox got it, the 6-0 redshirt junior from Altoona, PA. And this will be an inbound for the RedHawks near side of their offensive baseline for Wolf with 20 to shoot. Wolf will toss in, left wing outside the arc with it, Maddie Clouse. Bounce pass up top of the key. Near wing now, Ivy Wolf. And the MAC logo spins around off the window. Too much on it. A little bit too far left as well. Colonels over the timeline on the right wing. Hacker with the ball at the free throw line. This is out far corner. With it is Danielle Rainey. And her feed to the post area was deflected off an Eastern Kentucky hand. Maybe the hand of Fox out the baseline. RedHawks going to get it back here with 6:06 to go in the first. Ariel Kirkwood comes in for EKU. 7-4 RedHawk lead. Ivy Wolf will take the ball for the RedHawks in the inbound from Clouse. Return it back to Clouse to the right wing. Flips it over the timeline. Scott got the feed far corner. Shovels in near corner now. Wolf left wing. Three ball on the way. Too far right. An air ball by Claire Chambers. Goes out the baseline as Scott crashes into the cheerleaders. And Eastern Kentucky will inbound from their own baseline with 5:53 to go in the first.
Well, Patrick, Peyton Scott's right knee looks just about right now. I mean, we saw her drive down the baseline there, and she was moving at full speed. I think she probably could have gotten around that EKU defender into the bucket if she had really wanted to, but opted for the pass.
I agree. Almost 100%, maybe as close as you can get to it. Colonels with the ball here, right side of the paint. Little jumper too far left off the hands of Rainey. RedHawks get it back. Clouse takes over the timeline of the right wing for Miami. Miami up 7-4. Hands back to Chambers, top of the key. Near wing Scott with the ball, holds on outside the arc. Now Clouse, Wolf, far wing Chambers. Quick feed down low, and Clouse finishes wide open under the hoop of the right arm for two. Here's Racanati over the timeline, right wing Eastern Kentucky, to 9-4 RedHawk lead. She'll drive right side of the paint, flip a left-handed shot up and in on Ivy Wolf. Pretty good athletic move there by Racanati, the redshirt sophomore from Bergamo, Italy. 9-6 RedHawk lead. Far side outside the arc, Clouse gets it to the right elbow for Freeman, but she traveled after the feed. Took a step too many with the ball. The defender was on her. That was Walker. And we'll get our first media timeout of the game with 5 minutes to go in the first. Miami 9, Eastern Kentucky 6 so far from Millett Hall. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 5 minutes even left in the first quarter. Miami 9, Eastern Kentucky 6. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger with you courtside at Millett Hall in Oxford, Ohio so far tonight. We talked about going into the matchup. We thought it would be pretty even. So far it is, but really good sign. Peyton Scott looks flawless out there.
Yeah, Patrick, and we were talking in the commercial break, and at least I for sure am hoping that they just feed Peyton Scott all night tonight. So fun to watch on offense.
Sure has been. Long overdue for Red Hawk fans. Miami with the ball here in their own end. It was stolen away from Miami Wolf. Going to the rack. Walker for two with the left arm. She laid it in. Can't let Walker do stuff like that. She's going to take advantage. It's now a 9-8 Red Hawk lead. On the timeline, left wing of the ball, Watkins for the Red Hawks. She's in the game. Dishes back for Maddie Kloose. Top the key with it, Claire Chambers. Around the arc on the far side. Gets it back up top for Wolf. The left-handed dribble. Ivy to the near wing. Sydney Watkins on it for the Red Hawks with six to shoot. Watkins, right elbow, feeds down low. Freeman in the post was hit up high, contacted. The foul was drawn. As Kirkwood was in there, I believe Walker as well for Eastern Kentucky. And it's going to be Kirkwood who picks it up for her first with 4:12 to go in the opening quarter.
Patrick, going back a couple plays ago, the Colonels have four players on their team tonight that are averaging more than one steal per game, and Walker's averaging more than two, so the Red Hawks really going to have to take care of that basketball here tonight.
Red Hawks to the ball, get it to the right elbow. Jumper comes in there, too much on it from Morrow. Rebound picked up by Walker of Eastern Kentucky. The timeline feeds left wing. Reckon Natty's with it to the rack, up and under with the right arm. She's fouled. Red Hawk defense there was pretty strong, a little too strong. Chambers going to pick up her first. And with 4 minutes even to go in the opening quarter, 9-8 Red Hawks, a shooting foul whistle there to get Racanati to the line for two. Racanati. Richard, sophomore out of Italy. At 11 points against Tennessee on Sunday in Knoxville. First one is good to make it a tie game at 9 apiece. 83% free throw shooter on the year, Racanati. 10.7 points per game. That's third best on the team. Next one is good. So Eastern Kentucky, their first lead of the night at 10-9. You got substitutions for each team. The Red Hawks will inbound here on their own baseline, far away. It'll be close to send it in as Eastern Kentucky with a press here. Left wing, they get it to Watkins, who returns back for Kloose. Eastern Kentucky will kind of relax as the Red Hawks go over the timeline, middle of the floor. Close to the ball, goes over on the right wing, outside the arc, drives baseline, floats it up short with the right arm, but she was fouled. And a strong defense there came in from Walker with 19 to shoot. 3:48 to go opening quarter. It will be a shooting foul that will send Maddie Kloose to the line for two.
Patrick, interesting to see Eastern Kentucky in the press so early in this one. The Red Hawks, a few games ago, had 35 turnovers against Western Kentucky. Since then, they've only had 23 in two games, but certainly it's something that they've had to fight against this year, the persistent turnovers. So maybe Eastern Kentucky just trying to speed them up a little bit.
Yep. First one missed there by Kloose. 3:48 to go in the first. You get another one. That one is good. Tie game at 10, 3:48 to go first quarter. And it was Kirkwood's second personal on the foul for Eastern Kentucky. Girls over the timeline, left wing, Racanati goes down low to the left side of the post area where Walker tries his shot. It hung on the rim for a moment on the layup, then drop no good. Caruso on the timeline, middle of the floor, Red Hawks. Near wing feet outside the arc, Chambers. Right-handed dribble, gets it top the key, Sydney Watkins. Far side with it is Ivy Wolf. Right-handed dribble, drives her way baseline, will kind of come back out and fire a shot off the glass for two with both arms. In and out move there by Wolf, and the Red Hawks up 12-10. An athletic play, Racanati now, right-handed floater, good for the right elbow. Came down the right wing there on the timeline, drove right to the right elbow, a little floater with the right arm was good. We're knotted up at 12, 3 minutes to go in the first, and you get a foul here against the Red Hawks on offense. Wolf made contact away from the play on the far wing. It'll be her first of the night, and the Colonels get it back here in a 12-12 tie.
Patrick, it's all Walker and Racanati so far for the Colonels. 6 points each to make 12 for Eastern Kentucky. The one good thing, Red Hawks know who they need to stop.
Yeah, good point. Foul was here on the timeline right wing. It was Racanati. She was contacted by Sydney Watkins.
It's the team sport.
The university president just showed up and he's already barking. That's just not right. That's him. Your side with a walker from the paint. Spins around, up and under play. She got shut down there by Morrow. He's on the timeline, left wing of the RedHawks. Feed ahead to Watkins. Hits it top of the key, drives her way to the far corner. Now a cross-court pass, left wing three by Wolf is good. 15-12 RedHawks, 2:33 to go in the first. A huge three-pointer there by Ivy Wolf. Looking at, he's over the timeline, middle of the floor for the Colonels. Drives her way, open room, near side of the baseline. Kick out, far corner, three ball. Allie Collette, too much on it. Rebound in the hands of Walker, who then kicks it near corner, goes out of bounds on an errant pass to the baseline to Kalissa Lacey. The pace has picked up considerably here in the last minute or so with 2:17 to go in the opening quarter.
It really has, Patrick. You mentioned a beautiful three-point shot from Ivy Wolf there. So far on this season, she's only shooting a little bit below 33% from beyond the arc. So RedHawks would really benefit from getting her going. She's already such a prolific scorer, but if she could really take it to all three levels like that, it'd be huge for this Miami offense.
For sure. RedHawks up by three over the timeline, left wing. Wolf, right elbow pull-up. That's good for Ivy Wolf. Beautiful job and plenty of room, and the RedHawks lead by five with 2 minutes to go in the first. Racanati's over the timeline, middle of the floor for EKU. Drives her way to the far side near the Red Hawk bench. Now inside the arc, left elbow working up against Watkins. A flip shot goes up, was knocked away. Red Hawks over the timeline here on the left wing as Wolf will take the ball with a left-handed dribble. Feeds it to the far wing outside the arc as Sydney Watkins with it for Miami. Gets it down low where Kloose missed the feed, went out of bounds. It was 2 feet in front of her, and the Colonel's gonna get it back here on their own baseline with 96 seconds to go in the first quarter. Coming into the game is Lacey for the Colonels. Kirkwood will sit. Pretty decent crowd for this game. I think it's more than we had on Monday night.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting. The Oxford community enjoying a nice Friday night out here at Millett Hall.
Yep. Rainey top the key, hands it off to the near wing. Outside the arc, Lacey bounces up top, Walker. She'll just try a three, why not? Too far right, rebound kicks off the rim hard, goes out the baseline. And the RedHawks gonna get it back here, 1:18 to go on the first. They're up 17-12. Scott's gonna come back in the game, so will Riley Neal for the RedHawks. Kloose will take a break, so will Ivy Wolf for Miami. Inbound for Neal to Scott, left wing. And we'll then flip it cross court to the right side for Chambers. Back for Lacey on the timeline, middle of the floor. Near wing with it here, Peyton Scott with the ball. Left-handed dribble, flips it up to Watkins. Top the key now, Riley Neal. Far side, Chambers with it. Up top for Scott. Peyton Scott, right-handed dribble down the right side of the paint, off the window, it's good for two. Nice athletic move by Scott, flawless there. Miami up by seven. Near corner, Kirkwood for EKU, back in the offensive end. Top the key now, Racanati. With a right-handed dribble, Chambers guarding her, 18 to shoot. Racanati flips it back to Walker, the pass went behind her, and it's gonna go in the backcourt for a backcourt violation on the Colonels. The feed was over the head of Walker and 3 feet to her left. And the RedHawks will inbound here near side of the half-court line. As Scott will, never mind, it's going to be Neal to come over and throw it in. 38 seconds to go in the first quarter in a 19-12 RedHawk lead. Substitutions for EKU. Coming in is Fox. Going out is Kirkwood. Looks like Collette back in, and so is Kyra Freeman now for the Colonels. Near wing Watkins drives her way through the baseline and it's good with the up and under move for two with the right arm. 21-12 RedHawks. Lead by nine. 25 to shoot, there's 24 seconds to go. The shot clock about a half second in front of the game clock right now. So EKU with the ball top to Keith Freeman just dribbling it. In the shot clock slightly ahead by less than a second of the game clock at the moment. 8 seconds to shoot for EKU. Freeman, left elbow, drive left wing, down the side of the paint, too hard off the window with a left arm on the layup. 2 seconds to go, Scott, half court shot to win the corner is short. It's an air ball, and the first 10 minutes are over with here for the Red Hawks. The RedHawks with a very good first quarter, jack up 21-12 on Eastern Kentucky.
Yeah, Patrick, and it tells you a lot about Peyton Scott. When that half-court shot leaves her hand, you almost kind of feel like it's going to go in because she's just so skilled offensively. We've seen her here tonight. Really nice in the mid-range and a couple of really great finishes, too. She's just so slithery and strong when she's going to the basket. Once she's up in the air, there's no chance she's not going to make it work, somehow get that ball in the bucket. Like you said, nice little lead for these RedHawks going to the second.
So good to see that at the RedHawks end that first quarter on a 9-0 run, a 12-2 run in the last 4 minutes of this game. See if it continues going into the second. We're back in just a moment. This is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. Twenty-one-12, RedHawks lead Eastern Kentucky as we start the second quarter. Patrick Guest and Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett Hall here tonight. As the Colonels will inbound here near side of half court to get us started in quarter number two. Rainey throws into Racanati over the timeline on the right wing. It's Antoinette Walker with a quick pull-up left elbow. Is a little bit short. RedHawks to the rebound. Watkins takes it over the timeline here on the right wing. Flips near side for Scott, top of the key, Ivy Wolf with a right-handed dribble around the arc of the far side. Wolf left-handed dribble now to the near wing outside the arc, Watkins. Left side of the paint with it here is Peyton Scott. And she will be fouled? No, that's a foul on the RedHawks. Something away from the play, I think they got Riley Neal. Oh, Freeman, beg your pardon. Contact away from the ball, back to EKU. In the second quarter. Colonel send it in over the timeline, middle of the floor with the basketball is Racanati. 9:26 to go, second quarter, 21-12 RedHawks. Near wing outside the arc, Rainey with a ball, right-handed dribble, goes her way to the baseline and flipped it over the hoop, but is fouled on the shot. Don't know who got it for the RedHawks. Peyton Scott for her first, the team's second, and with 9:19 to go in the second quarter, it's going to be two shots at the line for Danielle Rainey, graduate student from D.C. First free throw short from Rainey, a 69.2% free throw shooter on the season. Next one good as well. The next one good, first one was missed. Coming in is Kirkwood, junior from Milwaukee. You got the RedHawks inbounding on their own baseline far wing. Ivy Wolf, rink wide, cross court pass Left side, Scott goes back up top the key for Kloose.
That's next weekend. Yeah.
It's an off weekend. Top of the key, Scott, far side, Neal, right wing outside the arc, drives her way in the MAC logo off the window, too high, rebound tipped out of bounds. And we'll go back to Eastern Kentucky. RedHawk hand got on it, out the baseline, that was the hand of Amani Freeman.
Eastern Kentucky substitution, number 13, Walker.
Walker's back in for EKU, they took out Kirkwood. Racanetti's on the timeline, middle of the floor for Eastern Kentucky. 8:50 left, second quarter. Miami up 21-13. Around the arc, near wing, Racanetti for EKU to the corner. Walker, pull-up jumper, right side of the elbow is good. 21-15, nothing but net. RedHawks lead with 8:35 to go in the second. Wolf left-handed dribble, near wing, will just fire off at three. Too far right, it hit the rim. Offensive rebound, though. Kloose kicks it top to Key Scott. Near wing with a basketball. Wolf drives away, left elbow. Jumper there was short. Rebound is fought for. It's going to be a foul on the RedHawks. Neal and Wolf are in there with some aggressive play against Fox. And Eastern Kentucky's Emma Hacker. This is going to go back to the Colonels here on their own baseline with 8:22 to go in the second.
Really nice move there by Ivy Wolf. A little hesitation, then she finds some space with the step back and just not able to hit the mid-range, but a good idea there from the sophomore point guard.
Yep. Racanetti's on the timeline, middle of the floor for Eastern Kentucky. On the big red M at half court, feeds it to the far wing with a basketball. Hacker with a right-handed dribble, gets it down left elbow. Here's Walker, drives away left side of the paint, off the window too high. Rebound RedHawks, right there was Freeman. Kloose over the timeline, middle of the floor. Around the arc in the right wing with a right-handed dribble, gets it back up top of the key. Freeman to the near wing, here's Watkins. Right-handed dribble for her, left elbow, trying to get a screen, fires off a jumper too hard. Freeman, though, collects the offensive rebound, far baseline for the RedHawks. Goes right wing outside the arc, here's Scott. Inside the arc, then feeds left wing, here's Morrow, back for Scott, top the key. RedHawks have eight to shoot, 7:33 to go in the second. Scott, right elbow, pull-up jumper, too much on it, but it bounced off the back of the rim and then fell through, 23-15 Miami.
What a crazy bounce there, but you feel like Peyton Scott did it on purpose.
Yeah. Racanetti in the far wing, definitely on purpose. 15 to shoot, far side EKU, Walker in the offensive end, holds on the ball, swatted away by Kloose. RedHawks cross forward on the floor and a fumble. And they call a jump ball, the possession arrow with Miami is gonna get it here with 7:06 left to go in the second. Into the game is Kirkwood for EKU. RedHawks inbound, far side of their offensive end. Scott gets it. 7:02 to go in the second quarter. Near wing with the ball is Morrow. Sidesteps the defender, back to Scott near half court. Right-handed dribble, hands it off for Kloose. Top of the key now, Watkins. Near wing outside the arc, Morrow. Back up top, Freeman. Far wing outside the arc, Scott, right side. Will fling a pass, back down deep in the far corner. That was Watkins. And we'll try to feather one through the leg of Emma Hacker. There's gonna be a foul whistle here on that play. It's gonna go on the Colonels. So Scott will inbound far side of the RedHawk offensive baseline. 6:41 to go in the second quarter. Finds Freeman right elbow, and we get a whistle here for a charge of the RedHawks. Freeman came in and kind of made contact with Fox away from the play. 6:38 to go in the second. Colonels get it back as the Red Hawk lead is 23-15.
Lacey, along with 13, Walker.
Fox will inbound for EKU on their own baseline on the far wing.
Katie Richardson for your Red Hawks.
Colonels team in there. Again, second true road game of the year. Their first one is at Tennessee on Sunday where they lost by a margin of 105-71. Right side at the elbow, Rainey will drill a jumper. Wide open for EKU. She kind of took it over the right wing and then had the room to get the jumper off and made it. 23-17 Miami. RedHawks to the ball on offense. Scott top the key, near wing with it is Watkins. To the corner, they feed it. Morrow three, too much. Rebound tipped out by Kloose, who gets it back here on the far corner. Kloose jumper is good. ends a scoreless drought of over 2 minutes for the RedHawks, who now lead 25-17. Top of the key, Racanetti to the far wing for Lacey. Right-handed dribble for her, feeds it to the left wing for Rainey. Quick feed down low to the left side of the paint. Fox working here up against Katie Richardson. Going to be a charge on Fox, who knocked over Richardson and made the shot, but it obviously will not count. Great defense there from the RedHawks. 5:43 to go in the second. RedHawks lead 25-17. You got Kloose inbounding to Scott. Over the timeline here on the right wing, RedHawks get it into the offensive end. Feed to the far side. Morrow kind of lost in her feet at the right elbow. RedHawks trying to fight for the ball, but the Colonels get it back. It was taken away there by Rainey, but there's a foul called here on Miami. Obviously, nobody likes the call, and this one he. I can't believe that he gets away with that.
It's fun to watch, though.
Oh, my God. Referees are talking about something here. I'm not sure what they called for a foul. I have no idea. It didn't seem like anything was obvious. And they're going to review something. So we got a media timeout during the review. We'll step aside for that and be back with the news of what they came up with in a moment. RedHawks lead 25-17. This is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. .5:29 to go in the second. It's a RedHawk lead of 25-17. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett all courtside tonight as the RedHawks search for win number 2 in a row. And it's going to be free throws coming out of a timeout for Eastern Kentucky. Going to the line is Danielle Rainey. So remember, we went to a review before that media timeout. It was the referees looking at a foul on the RedHawks. First free throw by Rainey is good. What they concluded was that Scott got her second personal going into that timeout, so second free throw now for Rainey. I have no idea what Scott did. Never saw it. Too hard on the second free throw by Rainey. Kicks it back out on the offensive board. Far side Racanati. Top of the key is a feed down low. That was Lacey who went to Walker and will finish with a right arm. 25-20, Red Hawk lead. Beg your pardon, is actually Kirkwood who made the layup. Her first points of the night. Near corner with the ball are the Red Hawks. Chambers gets it out far side, trying to feed over to Richardson, but it was picked off by Kirkwood. Up the right wing, here come the Colonels. Rainey, right wing three on a feed there to Lacey. She was short. Rebound for the Red Hawks. Morrow up ahead on the far side here for Watkins. Sydney Watkins, the right-handed dribble. Top of the key, hands it off for Maddie Kloos. Back up top, Richardson. Near wing with it is Chambers. Left side of the paint, off the glass, too hard. Maddie Kloos, with both arms there, was fouled on the play. And the RedHawks sophomore from Northfield, Ohio, looks like we'll go to the line here for two shots.
It's been a really impressive start to the season for Kloos. She's second among MAC scorers so far. 18.5 points per game. She's adding almost seven and a half rebounds as well. Shooting pretty efficiently.
Yeah, that rebound count leads the team for the Red Hawks. It was Walker who got her first personal. First free throw was good by Kloos. Next one at the line, too much on it, a little bit far left as well. So Kirkwood picks up the rebound over the timeline, right wing for EKU. Hits the brakes outside the arc, goes up top the key. Walker, right-handed dribble down the near side, will fling it off the window, too hard and too high. Rebound fought for, tipped off Walker's hand out the baseline. Red Hawks get it back here with 4:28 to go in the second. And a inbound from their own baseline as Emma Hacker comes back in for the Colonels. Coming out is Lacey. In the paint with it now is Maddie Kloos for the Red Hawks out of her own end over the timeline here on the left wing. Gets to the left elbow, pulls up, jumper, too far right. Rebound grabbed there by Kirkwood, who will take it over the timeline, middle of the floor for EKU. Kirkwood, left elbow, driving down the left side of the paint, off the glass, way too hard, it popped back out into the Red Hawks' hands. And Kloos with the basketball for Miami over the timeline, middle of the floor. Right-handed dribble for Maddie Kloos. Hands it off for Richardson. Top of the key now, Chambers. Far wing, Watkins. Holds on with both arms. Back up top for Kloos. 3:48 to go in the second quarter. Kloos right side jumper from just beyond the elbows. An air ball short. It's going to go out of bounds and back to the Colonels in a Miami 26-20 lead. Collette is back in for Eastern Kentucky. And the Colonel's inbound here as Rainey got the feed from Racanati at her own baseline. Rainey's over the timeline, left wing for the Colonels. Draws up a play, right-handed dribble for her, around the arc in the near side, gets to the baseline, will fire off a jumper, it's missed, she was fouled, knocked over by Chambers. So Claire Chambers is going to pick up her second personal foul. The sixth as a team on Miami. And to the line for two shots comes Rainey for the Colonels. First one is good from Rainey. Danielle Rainey is a transfer from Eastern Michigan. Of course, mentioned she's a grad student, so has played on this floor many times before. Next one is good. I think Yana Hendricks just called a timeout. She did. With 3:33 to go in the second, it is a Red Hawk lead of 26-22 as the Colonels all of a sudden jack on a 5-1 run in the last 2.5 minutes.
Yeah, and it was a really hot start for Miami, and they've kind of slowed down since then. They're only 1-for-7 from the three-point line. They were so good from there against Loyola Chicago in their best win of the season, probably 11-for-21,
yeah.
Over 50%. Before that, they were only shooting 26% from three on the year, so it kind of seems like they've fallen back a little bit into their old cold shooting ways. Be interesting to see if they can maybe heat up a little bit here going into the intermission.
Red Hawks are 1-for-4 in their last four field goal attempts. Miami team shooting about 45% from the field tonight. They're only 1-for-7 from outside the arc. Eastern Kentucky shooting 8-for-27 from the field, almost 30%.
Kind of surprising this game is so close when you look at those numbers.
Right. So Miami with the ball over the timeline here on the right wing. Kloos with it. Red Hawks lead by 4. Top of the key is Chambers. Far side outside the arc, Morrow. Top of the key now back for Richardson. Foul whistle. She was traveled. I don't know if Richardson traveled or Morrow did before she fed it over. But the referee right there called the travel. The RedHawks to be another turnover. Turnover's been a little bit of trouble for the RedHawks this season. That's already turnover number 11 on Miami tonight.
Yeah, that's really not good. We mentioned 35 two games ago against Western Kentucky, and the last two games only 13 and 10 respectively, so they're already up around there. Maybe part of the reason why they're shooting so well, but also not really winning this game by a whole lot.
Right. Rainey's over the timeline, middle of the floor for Eastern Kentucky with 3:08 to go on the second. Keys it to the near wing, outside the arc with it is Rainey. Right-handed dribble, gets it to the near wing for Hacker. Left-handed dribble to the near side, now Rainey's with it. Down low, right side of the paint, working as Walker up and under, move, the left arm was short. Rebound RedHawks over the timeline here on the right wing is Watkins. Lemmy with the ball here, still up by four. Watkins stripped away by Collette near half court. He's going to get it. Feeds Walker ahead. One-on-one back the other way with Chambers. Walker with a left-handed layup is good. You can't allow her to go down the floor in a one-on-one situation, and it's all of a sudden a two-point RedHawk lead. Loose is over the timeline on the right wing for the RedHawks. 2:25 to go in the second as Walker now has 10 in the game to lead EKU scores. Near side Watkins outside the arc, drives through the back logo in the paint, floats it off the glass too hard, but a foul is whistled. It's a block on Collette, who knocked over on the play for EKU. Not sure if this will be a shooting foul or not, and I think it will be, so they're going to send Watkins to the line here. She's a 2-for-2 free throw shooter on the season. She's got a pair of shots at the line here. First free throw good by Sydney Watkins, redshirt sophomore from Indianapolis. 3 points on the night tonight. Next free throw, a high one that goes in. 28-24, RedHawk back to a 4-point lead with 2:13 to go in the second. Racanetti's holding the timeline here, middle of the floor, feeds it off the hand of Watkins out of bounds. On the near side, got tipped out into the first row of the stands. And will be inbounded by EKU near side of their offensive end of the floor. It will be Racanetti to throw it in.
Great hand there by Sid Watkins. She's not the most offensively gifted player, but on defense, she's so intense and so athletic. Even coming off an ACL tear a couple of years ago, really a problem on the defensive side of the ball.
Right. 2 minutes to play. Racanetti near side of the corner for EKU. Spins out, floats it off the window. Too much on it. RedHawks will get the rebound in their own end. Close, a little bit of trouble over the timeline. Right wing hits the centering feet over to Morrow. Morrow gets it back. Far wing for Close. EKU there had a little bit of a press going. They relax it. Close to the rack, and a charge is whistled. The shot went in. But falling over was Hacker on the play. Eastern Kentucky draws it, and the ball going back to the Colonels.
No basket. Offensive foul call.
Really nice floater there from Clues. Would like to see her go back to that. Just unfortunate. The Eastern Kentucky girl or defender got to the spot first.
And it was, yeah, just that that got the foul called. 90 seconds to go in the second quarter. RedHawks lead by four. Near wing outside the arc with on the right side is Walker. With the right-handed dribble. Takes it down low to the baseline. Walker left side of the paint. Up and under move. That was beautiful there on Morrow. Textbook stuff back to a two-point game. Watkins over the timeline. Middle of the floor for the RedHawks with a right-handed dribble. 1:05 to go second quarter. Around the arc she'll go. Feed it top the key. Chambers holds on. Lost it in front of her. Picked up by Morrow. Free throw line. They feed it to the near corner. Goes out of bounds off the RedHawks. As Watkins was trying to get the feed and went past her. And the Colonels are going to get this one back and inbound it at their own end of the floor. Racanetti's got it. 53 seconds to go in the first half of the game. Racanetti right-handed dribble over the timeline, middle of the floor. Plays it there with Watkins. And a two-point Red Hawk lead. The intensity of this game has kind of ratcheted up the last couple of minutes. Racanati spins around left elbow. Room for a floater. Short off the rim. Red Hawk to the rebound. Chambers swoops in to grab it. Right wing feed for Clouse on the timeline here on the right wing. Back to the near side. Chambers holds on with both arms. Right-handed dribble back to the top of the key. Now it's Clouse here back in the big Red M at half court. 15 to shoot, 21 to go in the first half. They feed it far side. Watkins back to the baseline. Right wing feed off the window. Too strong for Amaro. But it's an offensive foul against Miami. Another one. And EKU get inbound here. The shot clock is off. There's 15 seconds to go in the second. A chance to either tie or take the lead into the half for the Colonels. Back over the ball on the timeline on the right wing with a left-handed dribble. Five to go in the second quarter. Far side Rainey will jump off a three. It's good. Never mind, they say it's two as she was on the arc. And we go to this game at halftime with a tie score. Miami 28, Eastern Kentucky 28. Not at all resembles what the scoring has been like throughout the first 20 minutes of this game. But this Colonels team, give them credit for climbing back, coming back in this game. The largest Red Hawk lead of that first half was 9 points. They had firm control at the beginning of that second quarter, but as the second quarter went on, the Colonels slowly but surely just fighting back, and now all of a sudden it's a tie game going into the second half of play.
Yeah, Patrick, and so far this season, the Red Hawks are actually outscoring their opponents in the first quarter. They're getting outscored by a lot in the next three quarters. Might be seeing that again once again today. They were winning by nine at the end of the beginning of the second. Now they're tied. We'll see if they can turn it back on coming into the third.
It's crazy. And a Red Hawk team, Peyton Scott was their big storyline coming into the game. She leads Miami with 9 points. Just played 11 minutes, though, in that first half. So that's a really good sign for the Red Hawks. But this Eastern Kentucky team, strength in numbers. Walker's been good. Rainey's been good. You've seen a lot from Racanati tonight. It's a Red Hawk team that's really struggling to defend this potent attack from so many people on the Eastern Kentucky side.
Yeah, and Eastern Kentucky is really just getting a lot of shots, a high volume, because Miami's turning the ball over so well, not doing an incredible job on the defensive boards, doing a pretty good job, but right, not getting every single one. So Red Hawks really just need to come into the second half and make sure that they're being conscientious with the basketball.
That's a big part of it, and a Red Hawk team that, again, turnovers have been a little bit of an issue as well, so the conscientious can be probably a big part of Deanna Hendricks' message in the locker room to her team.
Yeah, you would assume, and I'm going to be interested to see if they maybe shorten their bench a little bit going into the second half, because at least in my eyes, they really haven't gotten a whole lot in this game outside of their big three. And I'll add Sid Watkins. She doesn't contribute a ton on offense, but she's so good defensively. That's Clouse, Peyton Scott, Ivy Wolf, and Watkins.
Right.
So I would like to see that their best lineup for sure out on the floor a little bit more there in the second half altogether.
I agree. Going to be a pretty important second half for this Red Hawks team. They need to have a good start, put together a strong 20 minutes if they want to close out a win in this game, and a winnable game for sure against the Colonels here tonight. Halftime break for Millett Hall. Give us about 12 minutes or 13 or so, and we'll be back with you with the second half of play. From inside Millett on this Friday night, 28-28 your score. Eastern Kentucky and Miami all tied up. Third quarter comes your way in moments. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 28-20 at your score. We're about to begin our third quarter play here from Millett Hall. Patrick Getsch and Jack Schmelzinger are with you. A tie game between the RedHawks and the Colonels tonight here from Millett. And Jack, this is going to be one of those halves. The RedHawks going to find a way to win this game. Don't know how, don't know how pretty it's going to be. Just find a way.
Yeah, and they've been doing pretty well on defense so far, holding Eastern Kentucky to just 33% from the field. RedHawks just need to take care of the basketball a little bit better and maybe make a few threes.
Yeah. Top of the key, Colonels win the ball. Hacker feeds the near wing, racking that. He's outside the arc. Gets it top the key for Hacker to the far side with it. Is Rainey. Bounces down low, right side of the paint with it is Fox. Gets it right elbow, jumper short there from Walker. And the RedHawks corral the rebound. Scott's over the timeline on the right wing, feeds to Kloos with a three ball that's short. Rebound, get tipped out of bounds near sideline. This is going to go off an Eastern Kentucky leg, the leg of Hacker and out. And the RedHawks going to get the ball back here as we are 36 seconds into this third quarter.
Ball went directly to Greg Crawford. He's all over the place.
He teleports around this place. Top the key was Morrow, far side Kloos. Left elbow with it is Freeman. Jumper there is good from the left elbow. She was wide open. RedHawks lead it by a score of 30-28. With the ball top the key is Racanati for EKU. Left wing Rainey gets it down left side of the paint. With it is Walker. The right-handed hook shot. Good to the back logo. Went up against Sierra Morrow with the paint. Really good job by Walker. There's a reason why she's averaging 20 a game this year. Wolf top the key for the RedHawks at the offensive end to our right. Miami moving left to right across your radio here in the second half of play. Morrow left side, pull up for the elbow. Missed that, get tipped around. Here come the Colonels on the timeline. Left wing with it is Racanati. Down the right side of the paint. She'll drive coast to coast. It's going to the right arm off the window for two. And Eastern Kentucky leads it 32-30. Scott's over the timeline here in the left wing. And a whistle here for a foul that's going to go against the Colonels. Racanati fell over against Morrow. Colonel fans across the way didn't love the call. And you're going to have the foul here go up against Racanati for tonight or second. RedHawks hit the inbound, 20 to shoot. A little less than 2 minutes into this third quarter. Wolf near wing feed over there for Watkins. Down low to the baseline is Kloos. Right-handed dribble. She lost it on the floor. Colonels get it back. Here's Rainey over the timeline. Right wing for EKU. Rainey hits the brakes outside the arc. Drives her way to the corner. This one goes out of bounds. Out the baseline. Wolf there tapped it away. EKU inbounds here with 7:55 to go, third quarter. 32-30, Colonels lead it. Inbound, Figa tipped away, breakaway up the floor for the RedHawks. Sydney Watkins to the rack, and she makes the layup with a right arm off the window for two. Tie game at 32, back and forth we go inside Millett, coast to coast. Racanati floater short from the right elbow, rebound grabbed by Kloos. They tie up for it as Fox is in there too for the Colonels. Possession arrow is with Miami. And it'll allow the RedHawks to get it back here with 7:38 to go in the third on a jump ball whistle. Jacob DeGrom signs a 5-year, $185 million deal with the Rangers.
Wow. That's crazy. Might need to take a few plays off just to digest that one. Luke Westpulley would not be very happy.
Yeah.
That I heard Mets fan.
Far side outside the arc, EKU, the feed air it there. Here comes Scott, coast to coast, down the floor. The right-handed layup is good. 34-32, Miami with 7:25 to go in the third. Freeman's over the timeline, middle of the floor for Eastern Kentucky. What a game we got going so far. Left elbow with the ball was Walker. She traveled, trying to move her way down toward the paint. And the Mac logo on the RedHawks will send this one off here from their own baseline with 7:15 to go in the third. For RedHawks on the timeline here on the right wing. Freeman got it back near wing to Scott. The fallback jumper good from the right side of the paint. 36-32, 4-point RedHawk lead back to two possessions. Top the key, Racanetti, far side at the elbow. Walker with it, up and under, move. The left arm is good, off the window for two. Freeman's got it, feeds ahead here for Wolf. On the left-handed dribble over the timeline on the right wing. Passes a bouncer to Kloos. Left side, Scott, feeds cross court. Left wing with it, Watkins, whistle for a foul. It's going to go on the Colonels. And you're going to have Walker pick it up. For the team second, so Wolf will fire this one in far corner. Watkins, left wing, Scott, three ball is off, too far left. Rebound to the corner, it's going to be a foul here, I believe, on EKU. As Kloos is going after it with Kirkwood. Kirkwood made contact with her, gave her a shove. And you got the RedHawks inbounding here, up by two with 6:33 to go in the third. You got RedHawks inbounding the ball here, top the key with it was Wolf. Miami team 4-for-5 in their last five field goals. Left side is Kloos trying to feed near wing, goes out of bounds. Watkins there missed it. She was 3 feet to the right of the pass. And quickly inbounding of the Colonels.
Patrick Payton Scott tonight, 6-for-6 on mid-range jump shots or just shots inside the three-point line. Look to see her get a few more looks from there.
Yep. Collette left wing with it to the near corner with the ball. Lacey feeds down low, left side of the paint. Walker works here. Walker, Mack will go up and under, move with the right arm. She was fouled. Trying a hook shot from the right side of the paint. The foul whistle there is going to get Freeman her third of the night. First for the RedHawks as a team in this third quarter. 6:05 to go in the frame, and the Colonels will send Walker to the line here for two. 74% free throw shooter on the year is Antoinette Walker. First one ends in and out, pops away. No good, stays a 2-point game. Next one on the way here from Walker, redshirt senior from Illinois. That's good. So it's a 1-point game, 36-35. RedHawks hold on to the lead. Going to be an inbound here for Kloos. In the RedHawks zone end of the floor as EKU has the press going here.
Miami already forced Walker to commit four turnovers. If they can keep doing that, maybe a nice way to slow down Eastern Kentucky's most potent offensive option so far tonight. Really one of its only offensive options.
For sure. Inbound here, popped out of bounds off EKU. Kloos will send it in from the far side of the floor near the Colonel bench to our left. Got it into Scott and returns back to Kloos over the timeline. Right wing for the RedHawks. Hits the brakes outside the arc is Kloos. Up top the key for Peyton Scott with the ball. Hands it off here for Wolf. Back up top the key, Kloos. Near wing with it, Watkins. With a left-handed bounce around the arc. Whistle here for a foul is on the Colonels. Collect just got her second with a run in there with Scott away from the ball. Watkins will throw it in for the RedHawks near side of their offensive end with 5:44 to go in the third.
Patrick Kloos just hasn't quite been the same player she's been for the rest of this year tonight on offense. Only 6 points so far. She's averaging 18, like we said, second among max scorers so far this year, but she does have 8 rebounds.
Right.
Still in danger of putting up a double-double. That's a good basketball player right there.
Still an impact, yep.
Yep.
Top of the key, Scott. Far wing, RedHawks work. Offensive end, Kloos outside the arc. Morrow back for Kloos. 8 to shoot for the RedHawks. Tosses back for Wolf. Left elbow jumper, that's good. Nothing but net for Ivy Wolf. Those are the shots you need at this point in the game. 38-35 Miami.
She has been so good from the mid-range so far here tonight.
From the field, Wolf 3-for-7 this evening. Left wing, 3-try, wide open, too much on it. Was Lacey, it bounced off the rim, went over the backboard and out. And with 5:11 to go in this third quarter, it's gonna be an inbound for the RedHawks in their own end of the floor, up 38-35 on the Colonels. Freeman's back in for the Colonels. Inbound will come as another press from EKU by Kloos on her own baseline for the RedHawks. Left wing easy feed to Wolf, back for Kloos. Over the timeline, left wing, Maddie Kloos with plenty of time. Far side with it is Ivy Wolf. Just gonna bark some orders, drop a play here. Hands it off for Kloos. Near wing outside the arc with it is Watkins on the right side. Watkins up top to Key Wolf. Far side, Chambers goes down low, right side of the paint. Wolf got body slammed there to the floor. As she tried to make the shot, she's okay, but a foul was whistled.
What a beautiful pass there from Claire Chambers. Finds Wolf cutting to the back door and able to draw a foul there. RedHawks going to get a couple shots coming out of this media timeout.
That'll be a welcome sight for a RedHawk team that needs all the points they can get right now. They're up by three, 38-35, 4:48 to go. Quarter number three. We'll step aside just a moment. Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. .448 to go in quarter number three. Miami 38, Eastern Kentucky 35. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back to the court side here inside Millett Hall in Oxford. Well, it's been a pretty entertaining second half so far. Back and forth we've gone.
Yeah, it has. And outcome of this one is certainly still in doubt. RedHawks, like we said, coming out of the halftime break, they've done a pretty good job so far limiting the turnovers, but definitely got a long way to go in that department. We'll see if they can keep doing it.
At the line is Ivy Wolf for Miami. First free throw is good from her. 5'8 sophomore guard from Minster, Ohio, was fouled before we went to the media timeout. That's one good as well from Wolf. She has now 11 points rather the night tonight. So now that makes 482 in her career through 35 games, 18 away from 500.
Yeah, and I was reading she's probably going to be one of the top five fastest ever to do it in Red Hawk history. Yep. Pretty impressive stuff.
Right elbow with it is Walker for EKU. Fires up a jumper, too much on it. Rebound Red Hawks. Morrow hands off to Wolf over the timeline here in the left wing. Ivy Wolf left-handed dribble down the left side of the paint. Puts it off the glass. Too much, but a foul is whistled on Wolf. An offensive foul as she charged over Kyra Freeman. It's Miami 7. Deonna Hendricks does not like the call. Go ahead.
It was just a really strong take there from Ivy Wolf. It really didn't look like that Colonel defender quite had her feet set. But.
No. Freeman dishes back, top the key. Lacey's with it, back to the near corner for Freeman. 15 to shoot. Freeman across the paint, dishes back, top the key. Three ball is off and good. Lacey sunk it. That's a huge shot to knock it back to a two-point game. Close. Left-handed dribble, right side of the paint. Tosses back for Wolf up top the key for Miami. Hands it off for Watkins. Back up top, Chambers. Near wing, Close. 13 to shoot. Wolf, far side for Chambers. We'll go to Morrow, top the key. She'll fire off a three. It's good. Wide open, Morrow. And Walker on her, but she was a few feet away. And the RedHawks make it back to a five-point game. Rainey's got it at the RedHawk M at half court for EKU. Foul whistled here. She was harshly defended by Watkins. A little bit too aggressive, according to the referee. That's going to be the second foul on Watkins tonight. Third as a team for Miami in quarter number three. 3:27 to go in the frame. It is a 43-38 RedHawk lead. Racanati throws it in. The give and go with Rainey. Back for Racanati. Near side outside the arc. Freeman with the ball for EKU. Freeman right side of the paint. Hits the break. Spins around. Floats it off the window. Too hard with the left arm. RedHawks the rebound over the timeline. Left wing is close. Near wing with it. Here's a jumper. Wide open. Watkins too far left. Rebound tipped off the hand of Walker. Back out outside the arc for the RedHawks. Wolf comes up with a left-handed pull-up from the left elbow. It's good. 45-38 Miami, 2:55 to go in the third. RedHawks get their own rebound too, or the ball back on a turnover, back to their own end, and score again. As Close got it to Wolf in the free throw line area. She put it in for two, and a timeout called by the Colonels. So after that initial Wolf jumper, the ball on the inbound is turned back over by the Colonels. It was the RedHawks who got on it. A feed to Wolf in the free throw line area. She made another jumper. And 47-38 Miami, quite a stretch there.
It sure was. Great stuff by Ivy Wolf. Two made jumpers in a row, like you said. And that brings her up to 15 points in this game. It would be her third consecutive game with 20 points. And after those two shots, Eastern Kentucky needs a timeout.
That they do. First one called in the game by their second-year head coach in Greg Todd here with 2:44 to go in the third. And the last stretch of play for the RedHawks puts them on a 7-0 run in the last 90 seconds. That's what Miami needed coming into the second half, just to kind of get some breathing room and space.
Yeah, absolutely, Patrick. And what do they say? The college basketball is a game of runs. And that is certainly the truth here for Miami. Nice little 9-point lead now here, and we'll see if they're able to keep it up. Another thing that, looking at the quarter breakdowns from this year, they've also done a little bit better in the third quarter than they generally do in the fourth, so we'll be able to see if they can really hold on in this one, keep the effort all the way up for the last 12 minutes or so.
Yeah. An immediate timeout, by the way. RedHawks are going to be at Northern Kentucky. They've got a long way to go until their next game, not till December 11th, so that'll be over a week from now. They'll be in Highland Heights to take on the Northern Kentucky Norse. That's a 2 o'clock start. Their next home game will come on Friday, December 16th. That's 2 weeks from tonight against Bradley at 7 o'clock, followed by a home game the next day. That's Saturday, December 17th, when they take on Oakland University of Detroit at 5:30.
Patrick, we got another game coming up tomorrow on RedHawk Radio.
Miami, Indiana State on the men's side of things. Indiana State's hot, 7-1 coming into Millett this year.
Wow, and RedHawks coming off a really nice game last time. 95-78 win over Jackson State, who's, according to RPI, was looking one of the top five worst teams in college basketball. So you take what you can from that victory. We'll see if they can build on it and maybe have a good showing against a really good Indiana State team, at least what looks like one so far.
They're talented. One of the favorites early in the season in the Missouri Valley Conference, which it's not a Power 5, but it's pretty darn good basketball league, so they're the real deal.
Absolutely.
Sycamores will come in here tomorrow at 1 o'clock Eastern time. The tip, our coverage on RedHawk Radio begins at 12:30 Eastern with the pregame show. 47-38 Red Hawk lead out of Armenia timeout with 2:44 to go third quarter. And EKU will inbound far side from their offensive end of the floor. Daniel Rainey bounces in there to Racanati, who hits the brakes from the right elbow. This is back out for Rainey. Bounces it to the right side of the paint. Walker, left-handed dribble, will put it up and off the glass for two in the right arm in the paint. Went up against Kloose and won the battle handily. Redhawks work it up the right way. Quick three chance. Chambers sinks it. The loudest this building has been all night as the Redhawks lead now by 10. Top the key with it, Racanati gets it to the right side of the paint. Walker for EKU, right wing three now. It's Lacey, that's good, she'll sink it. Lacey's been sneaky good. She's 2-for-4 from outside the arc tonight. 6 points, 50-43 Miami, 2 minutes even to go in this third quarter. Near wing is Kloose for the ball for the Redhawks. Around the arc she'll go, top the key Wolf, far side with it, Watkins. Back up top the key for Morrow. To the right elbow, spins back out up top the key. Here's Wolf, 7 to shoot. Ivy Wolf around the arc, bounces far side for Watkins. Gets it to the baseline, trying to flip up a layup, missed it, and the putback attempt. She got the ball back, ran out of time. The shot clock ran out. Good effort there, but just not enough time. Or was there a foul called on EKU? I believe that's the case.
Interesting, and I think they're actually going to call the foul on the second shot from Sid Watkins. She kind of threw it up there and it bounced off right back to her. I don't even know if it hit the window or not, but it came right back to her. She threw it up again, a real desperation shot that had no chance of going in.
No. So they're going to review it, and I bet what they're looking at to see is did the shot, the second opportunity for a shot, come before the shot clock expired or after it. If it occurred after the violation, then the foul wouldn't count, but if it was beforehand, then obviously it's a different story.
Makes sense.
1:37 left in this third quarter. Redhawks lead by 7.
It was a really nice take there from Sid Watkins. She just, sometimes it seems like she gets moving a little bit too fast and she can't really quite just get that shot up exactly as she wants it to while she's moving so fast.
Right.
Might like to see her slow it down a little bit once she got toward the basket sometimes. But she's so fast, so quick, helps her get to the basket, which she has done pretty easily every time she's tried here tonight.
Officials are done talking about this. They're going to say 2 shots at the line, I think. So the foul was on Lacey for her first. So the foul did occur before the shot clock expired, and at the line for a pair of shots now, Cindy Watkins. And returns to the line tonight, being 2-for-2 this evening from the stripe. This one good from Watkins. 7 points on the evening for her. Second one too strong from Watkins. Rebound picked up by EKU. They had numbers deep, far corner with it. Hacker comes out of her own net. Feeds middle of the timeline, Recanti. It's the near wing in the corner. Rainey drill, send a 3 too far right for the near side of the floor. Wolf with the rebound for the Redhawks on the timeline right wing. Here's Kloose. Outside the arc, goes top the key with it, Morrow. Hands it back for Ivy Wolf with a right-handed dribble, 17 to shoot. Wolf back up top the key, around the arc, feeds it down. Low right-handed layup, good by Morrow on an athletic play. She had no room to work with, but somehow got the feed and put it up and off the glass for 2 with 2 defenders on her. 53-43, back to a 10-point Redhawk lead. Ties their largest of the night. Lacey top the key for EKU, feeds down low to the far elbow, and then a Walker drove over Wolf for the travel. Costly foul for Walker.
Yeah, it really was, and so far it seemed a little bit like these referees are not the most consistent on these charge calls. Once again, it really didn't seem like Ivy Wolf quite had her feet set there, but certainly take it as an admitted Redhawk homer.
Yep. So press on for EKU. Redhawks inbound. Kloose sends it to Wolf. Back to Kloose. 45 seconds to go, third quarter. Up the left wing on the timeline of the ball is Watkins. hits the brakes up high on the left side. Red Hawk offensive end, 20 to shoot for Miami, 35 seconds now left in this third quarter. Watkins with a right-handed dribble up top the key with the ball. Gets it down low, left side of the paint. Clues works and gets it off the glass for two with both arms. Great athletic stuff from Miami, the offensive post tonight. 55-43, the Red Hawk lead. Shot clock is off, 15 seconds to go in this third quarter as the Colonels will try here for the final shot. Freeman dribbles at top of the key, trying to drop a play. Six to go. Freeman down the left side of the paint, floats it off the glass. Short rebound, Ivy Wolf, 2 seconds left. Far side feed, Chambers floats it from half court off the backboard. A little bit high. And the third quarter over with from Millett Hall with Miami on top of Eastern Kentucky. 55-43, the Red Hawks went into the halftime break tied up at 28 with the Colonels. They emerged from the third quarter with a 12-point lead, and what a third quarter it was for Miami.
It really was impressive stuff from the Red Hawks. They started spreading the ball around a lot more. We said going into that second half, it felt like they were only getting contributions on offense from about three of their players. Now they've got Maddie Klus at 8 points, Sierra Morrow at 7, Peyton Scott 13, Ivy Wolf obviously 15. She was excellent in that third quarter. Sid Watkins has 7 of herself, so really a nice quarter from the Redhawks. Nice job on offense spreading that ball around.
Yes, big time as they introduced the students who were lucky enough to win $500 for showing up tonight on the floor.
Sometimes I'm starting to think they rig it against the broadcasters. I mean, we're here like every game. I've never won it.
We'll have to check in on that.
Yeah.
Use your newspaper stuff.
Honestly.
Investigate.
Have to go talk to Dave Meyer over there.
Yeah.
See what he has to say.
I agree. All right, 12-point Red Hawk lead. Step aside for just a moment before this fourth quarter gets underway. Miami basketball on Red Hawk Radio. Fourth quarter about to get underway from Millett Hall tonight. 55-43, the Red Hawk lead over Eastern Kentucky. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett Hall. Really strong third quarter from the Red Hawks, who take a 12-point lead into the fourth. Can they hold on to it? That's the question. Pull out a big win against the Colonels tonight. Eastern Kentucky will start the fourth quarter off with a ball. Rainey, a left wing three, was short. And the rebound to the Red Hawks. Wolf over the timeline, middle of the floor for Miami. Ivy Wolf around the arc to the near wing. She's the leading scorer for the Red Hawks tonight with 15. One of two Miami players in double figures. Scott has 13 this evening for the Red Hawks. Scott dribbles it down low. Left side feed at the paint. Morrow off the rim. A little bit too hard there. Rebound Walker for EKU. Feeds far side over the timeline on the right wing is Racanati. Hands it off for Collette down the paint area. Trying to fling one off the bottom of the rim. It was short. With the right arm on a layup attempt, here comes Klus over the timeline right wing for the Redhawks. Klus hits the brakes, left side of the elbow. This is back top the key. Freeman down low with the ball. Morrow hits the brakes, right side of the paint. And we'll put it off the rim a little bit too short, but a foul whistled on a shot attempt. It'll go against Emma Hacker for her first.
At the line for your RedHawks, Sierra Morrow with two shots.
Morrow's got two at the line with a minute gone by in this fourth quarter. First one is good from Sierra Morrow, junior from Minneapolis. 8 points now in the night for her. Played 23 minutes this evening. Next one is good. 57-43, the Red Hawk lead. Extended to 14, its largest of the night with 8:55 to go fourth quarter. Near side of the feed here to Daniel Rainey for EKU on the offensive end outside the arc. Goes top of the key for Emma Hacker. Down low, baseline, up and under, move. It's good with the right arm by Racanati, who kind of floated it in. And the Red Hawks here will take it over the timeline. Left wing, Ivy Wolf in a 57-45 Miami lead. Wolf, a left-handed dribble outside the arc in the near wing. She's going to hand it off here for Morrow. Back up top of the key for Peyton Scott with the ball. Scott's around the arc, right elbow, drives down the right side of the paint, whistle for a foul. She was contacted making a shot attempt that was short. It's a block on Collette for her third, and the Red Hawks inbound on the second foul as a team against the Colonels in this fourth quarter. Into the game now, Chambers for Miami coming out is Morrow. And they're also going to bring in Bridget Fox for EKU coming up for the Colonels is Collette. Inbound from Wolf. Far corner goes. Scott will pull up with a jumper. Way too much on it. Rebound easily corralled and grabbed there by EKU as Walker. On the timeline right wing, Racanati will drive her away. Hit the brakes. Free throw line. Kick it out far side. Three ball is good. A long range one from Hacker. And all of a sudden, the lead is knocked to 9 at 57-48.
Beautiful shot from Hacker. She's 6'3" shooting from beyond the arc.
Here's an and-one chance for the Red Hawks. Close, put it in for two from the MAC logo with a floater in the paint. And a chance for her to go to the line for a three-point play with 7:55 to go in the fourth. Tell you what, Eastern Kentucky does some good stuff on offense, but Miami really quick to respond tonight.
Yeah, and really, that's a great way to keep momentum in your favor. It's easy to kind of put your head down after a made three, but if you just go right back down the court and punch right back, Red Hawks don't lose any momentum there. And all of a sudden, Maddie Kluse, one rebound away from a double-double.
Yep. Made the second free throw, 60-48, the Red Hawk lead. Far side with it, Racanati for EKU, hits the brakes. Outside the arc, puts it top to Key Fox, near wing of Rainey. Right-handed dribble, knocks it down low, picked off there by Scott. It was a feed going to Fox. Scott over the timeline here on the right wing. Will try to dish it back. She will. Wide open three. Wolf top the key. Too far left. Rebound for Rainey over the timeline. Right side EKU. With a left-handed dribble, Rainey gets her way down left side of the elbow. This is back top the key for Hacker. And here with feed got tipped out. Good job by Scott to get in the way. They were trying to move it down low. The Colonels were. Right side pulling up. Three ball close. It got tipped away and out of bounds. And this will stay with the Red Hawks. Went off an EKU handout to baseline with 7:06 to go in the fourth. Lacey's coming in for the Colonels. Coming out is Hacker. And it looks like EKU also wants to bring in Ariel Kirkwood. Coming out for her will be Rainey. So you got Scott to send it in. In her fourth appearance of the year, kicks it out far corner, wide open Chambers, too far left on the three ball, tipped out of bounds off of a Red Hawk hand. It was Scott out the near corner of the Red Hawk offensive end of the floor, and the Colonels will inbound here with 7:02 to go on the fourth.
Patrick, this is just such a different team with Peyton Scott out there. Not only does she take focus off everyone else on offense, you can just tell she's such a leader, so intense out there. Really just brings an aura of preparedness to this Red Hawk team.
Seriously. Scott stole the ball away in the Red Hawks end of the floor from Walker. Feeds left wing for Wolf. Far corner close, near corner Chambers. Right wing Scott outside the arc, drives in, kicks it left side of the paint. Freeman off the window for two. For 2 points for Freeman, who adds to the frenzy there. Great sequence by the Red Hawks. Scott stole it away and then All kinds of great ball movement by Miami. The offensive end to get the 2 points. Kirkwood kicks it back out for Acanti. Now driving in from the top of the key. Lacey off the glass for two for the Mac logo on the paint. Luce will fire it far side here for Wolf. Cross court, right wing Scott. Back to the left wing for Wolf. Holds on to an outside the arc in the left wing. Wolf still with the ball. 6 minutes to go, fourth quarter. Red Hawk lead by 12. At 62-50. Near side on the screen, three ball, Chambers too far right. Redhawks three-pointers have not been going in very much here in the last few minutes. Far side, Racanati with it for EKU. Gets it to the near side, outside the arc. Lacey, left wing three, popped it out. Rebound to the Redhawks. Here's Scott over the timeline, middle of the floor. Drives her way, kicks it out right wing. Wolf, wide open three, it's good for Ivy Wolf. 18 points tonight for number four in white to lead all scorers. Timeout, Eastern Kentucky. Greg Todd has had enough. It's a full timeout. It's also a media timeout from here inside Millett Hall. But Jack, we knew the Redhawks have to take on a big second half to pull out a win in the game. They've done everything and more to do that so far in half number two tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. And especially the last few minutes of this fourth quarter, it's really just been so dominant for Miami. Peyton Scott, we noted three straight steals on three straight EKU possessions. She almost got another one. She got her hand on the ball in that fourth one. And Redhawks is doing so well on offense. Big three there from Ivy Wolf. That will really just help give the Redhawks a little bit more momentum there. And you got to figure 5 minutes left, a 15-point lead for Miami. They really shouldn't, in theory, have any trouble closing this one out.
Not at all, but we'll see. It's why they play the rest of the game. 5:23 to go in the fourth. Back in a moment. This is Miami basketball on Red Hawk Radio. .523 to go in the fourth quarter for Millett Hall. Miami 65, Eastern Kentucky 50. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with you inside Millett Hall tonight. Side of the court. Just got to close it out if you're Miami in these last 5:23.
That's right. If they continue to play good defense like they have been so far this quarter, in this half especially, Redhawks should have no trouble closing this one out. It'd be a nice big win to get back toward 500 here on this non-conference season.
Good point. There's this pretty good crowd in Millett Hall tonight. Excited to watch this finish. Pretty good amount of students here tonight, which is interesting.
Yeah, not a lot of Friday night basketball games often, like you were saying before.
You're going outside the arc. EKU starts with the ball. Left side of the paint. Walker working in the paint. She spun around and made a nice shot with the left arm, reaching around Morrow to get it in for two. Start us out from the timeout, 65-52 Red Hawk lead. And your wing outside the arc, Payne Scott with the ball for the Red Hawks. Top of the key for Ivy Wolf with 15 to shoot. Trying to hand a dribble Wolf to the near wing. Here's Watkins. Back up top for Wolf. Left elbow, kicks it out. Watkins, three ball. Too much on it. RedHawks can't get the rebound. Racanati's with it over the timeline here in the right wing. Drives her way through the Mac logo. Got swatted out of the air by Watkins for a foul. She came through and made a violent attack on the ball. It's going to be a two-shot trip to the line coming up here for Racanati.
Patrick Watkins can't escape the foul, but she certainly earned that one.
Yeah.
She's going to make sure Racanati thinks twice next time she tries to go up with Sid Watkins in the area.
Mm-hmm. Her third for Watkins. You're going to have Chambers come back in. Scott's coming out. 21 minutes tonight for Scott. That's a season high. She's played 15, most in a game this year, which was Loyola on Monday. She played 15, also 15 at Evansville on Saturday. Free throw good there by Racanati. She's got one more coming up on this trip. Too hard. Rebound in the hands of the RedHawks. Watkins gonna whistle for a foul. It's gonna be on EKU coming back down the floor, and the RedHawks here will, I guess, inbound far side of the floor near the half court line as Racanati got her third. Contact in transition. So the inbound sent in, a give and go with Wolf for Racanati over the timeline left wing, and a whistle here, and this will be a foul on the RedHawks. Not sure what that was all about. No idea.
Yeah, honestly, I don't know the rules of basketball well enough, I have to admit.
I don't either. Your side outside, you're Kirkwood. Got it to the near corner, EKU back on offense. Lacey in the middle, and it's off the glass and in for an and one from Walker. 10-point Red Hawk lead and a chance to make it nine for Walker. Red Hawk second foul as a team with 4:22 to go in this fourth quarter. Gonna have a free throw at the line here for Walker. Try to make it a 9-point game as Morrow got her second personal on the play. Contact in the hoop area. First one good, the only one good by Walker. EKU sends Freeman in, and all of a sudden, Jack, 4:22 to go on the fourth. It's an interesting one now with a 9-point advantage.
Yeah, it really is, and if you're Miami, you really don't want to let this one get any closer. It'd be really big to score some points here on this next possession.
Watkins with it far away to the middle. Here is the RedHawks over the timeline, middle of the floor for Kloose. Hands it off there for Ivy Wolf, back to the far side, Watkins, top of the key, Kloose down the left side of the paint, off the glass for two, but she was fouled, did not go in, I should say. And the foul will go up against Kirkwood on a two hard shot by Kloose. Left side of the paint, 4:05 to go in the fourth, and to the line for two shots, Maddie Kloose. EKU gonna bring a couple new players into the game.
And 22, Lacey.
Hacker and Lacey will come in. Referees here discussing something. I don't know what the confusion was all about, but I think they're just going to go into the two free throws here from Kloose. 11 points tonight for Kloose. First one's good. Just one of three RedHawks in double figures tonight. Kloose now at 12 points. Scott has 13. Wolf leads all the RedHawk scorers with 18 tonight.
Wolf looking once again for her third straight 20-point game. See if she can score another two before this one ends.
Second free throw popped it out. Racanati coast to coast with a rebound. The right-handed layup missed over the hoop. Close to rebound in the RedHawks end. Near wing feed for Wolf. Far side now. This will be going back the other way as traveling was Watkins. Step too many on the far wing as she drove her way down the left side of the court. So EKU with the ball over the timeline, middle of the floor. With it is Racanati. Right-handed dribble to the far wing, hits the brakes at the far elbow with the ball. Here's Lacey with it in the MAC logo, and it's a floater off and into the hoop for two with the right arm. Timeout called by the Colonels. Greg Todd would like to use one here. It's now a 66-58 game with 3:33 to go in this fourth quarter of play. So Miami's been a little bit slow here in these last few minutes. EKU on an 8-1 run in the last 2 minutes of the game, and this is not a good trend for the RedHawks.
Yeah, and we kind of have been talking about it all game. RedHawks have really had a lot of trouble closing out games here this year, and once again, they're seeing this one get a little bit close toward the end, even though it looked like it was pretty much over with, you know, probably about 7 or 6 minutes left. And I think that's a good time to call a timeout if you're Eastern Kentucky. They really do have a chance here at eight points down with 3.5 minutes to go.
Yep. Just going to have the ball inbounded from Miami on their own baseline. EKU going to send the press on here for Kloos. Is going to send it in for Miami. Kloos going to run to the near side of the baseline from the far side. She'll flip one up in the air. Morrow trying to chase down the breakaway, and a foul is whistled. In a foot race the other way, it's going to go up against Emma Hacker. And Hacker made contact in a race to the ball with Morrow as they were rushing it down. The inbound came from the Red Hawk baseline by Kloos. She just threw a pass downfield that was out of the reach of everybody, chased after by Morrow when she was kind of up there with Hacker, and Hacker made contact with Morrow. The referee called a foul, and now they're going to review it.
Yeah, and the referee made a hand motion that I've never really seen before. It was the interference in hockey, the arms crossed in front of him. And Hacker looked a little bit scared when she saw that. I don't know what it means. Yeah. I don't know if she does either, but...
So they're going to it's an intentional foul. That's what the signal means. And her third personal.
All I caught that the ref said to Steve Baker right there was intentional foul. So
yeah. Intentional meaning it was on purpose, as the two were racing toward the ball. Hacker made purposeful contact with Morrow. So two shots to the line. Ivy Wolf is at the line for the RedHawks. First one is good. Of course, you send your best free throw shooter in these situations to the stripe. So Wolf, over 90% of the year, will go 2 for 2.
Yeah, it's kind of funny. Miami men's has Makai Larry, who's really a world-class free throw shooter throughout all of college basketball. Even the NBA, a lot of guys do not shoot as well as him. And Ivy Wolf, also one of the best from the charity stripe in Division I.
So he'll be sent in. The RedHawks get the possession too after the intentional foul. Wolf will fling it over the timeline, left wing for Kloos. In the far corner goes for Morrow, who will drive a floater through the lane. It's good. And with the right arm, 3:20 left in the fourth. Miami leads by 12 at 70-58. Top of the key with a basketball is Recknati for EKU. This is back for Freeman. Top of the key to the near wing, Rainey. This is inside for Walker. Walker, left side of the elbow, will get it down to the far corner. Here's Racanati, driving baseline, kicks it out top of the key. Three ball there is good, nothing but net from Daniel Rainey. And now it's back to a 9-point game at 70-61. EKU's been kind of good from outside the arc in the fourth quarter. Up ahead over the line on the right wing is Watkins. For Miami, going to be crunch time of the game. 2:35 to go in the fourth. They kick in near corner. Wide open three. Missed too far right there by Morrow. The rebound is battled for. It's won by EKU. Racanati's over the timeline here on the right wing. Feet to the near side for Collette. Top to Keith Freeman. Far side, Rainey. With the ball, kicks it out. Three-pointer short. Rebound is going to be fought for. A foul is whistled as you had Walker get her hands on it. Red Hawk player kind of knocked her over. That was Wolf. And it will be shot to the line, I think, here for EKU. Never mind, it'll just be an inbound for the Colonels. So Walker going after the rebound is shoved over by Wolf. OKU will inbound. 2:15 to go, fourth quarter. Miami leads by 9 points, 70-61 to score. Your side of the baseline sent in there by Rainey to the corner. It's a three ball that's good from Rainey. 6 point game now, 70-64 Miami. RedHawks on the timeline right wing. Close drives down, whistle for a charge. She knocked over Collette in the lane. 2:03 to go in the fourth. Miami 70, Eastern Kentucky 64, and the Colonels get the basketball back.
Patrick, if I'm Miami, I'm really trying to slow the ball down here, try to eat up a little clock. This game's getting really close, and every second counts. Miami really didn't even go into the next 10 seconds of the shot clock there. Just a really, really quick shot, and it wasn't really that great of a shot either.
No.
Luce really had to fight through traffic to get that ball up.
They're going to review, I believe, this last play. Or they're talking to the scorer's table about it.
Patrick, Peyton Scott went out with about 4.5 minutes left. RedHawks had a 15-point lead. You kind of thought, okay, Peyton Scott's done for this game. They just put her back in.
Yeah.
Guessing Deanna Hendricks probably also thought she wasn't going to have to use her star player anymore.
Right. Kind of have to now. 70-64 Miami with 2:03 to go in the fourth. They are reviewing something at the table.
Right.
On the far side of the floor. And referee's going to tell everybody to go back to their benches. So it's kind of a de facto timeout here for each team, too. EKU on a 6-0 run in the last minute 20 of this game. The RedHawk team, it looked really good going into the fourth quarter. They had the 15-point lead, but then all of a sudden, 6-point advantage now for the RedHawks on this Eastern Kentucky huge push in the last not even 90 seconds.
Patrick, it's kind of funny. It's almost like a Miami thing. We've seen Miami hockey, at least since I've been here, have so much trouble late in games. Miami women's basketball also doing the same thing. I remember Miami baseball last year had a lot of bullpen troubles, so just interesting.
I agree. I'm
sure there's probably really no overarching cause for it. But.
So the referees are done with their review.
He called an offensive foul on against Miami.
And I guess they conclude they were going to look to see if the foul actually happened. And they conclude the foul did happen on the RedHawks. Close. So here we go, Eastern Kentucky down by 6 with the ball on the timeline. Middle of the floor with 2 minutes to go in the game. Far side, outside the arc, Lacey on the right wing. Feeds near side, Rainey tries another three. Too far left, offensive rebound, EKU, but Collette grabbed it and stepped out of bounds on the baseline with her left foot. That's a key break for the RedHawks, who will inbound it here from their own end of the floor. Kloos will send it in with 1:49 to go in the fourth quarter. Full court press for EKU. Kloos sends it in for Wolf, back for Kloos. Who then will two-hand feed it up the left wing for Wolf. Near side, Kloos with the ball, gets it over the timeline. Far side, Wolf to the corner for Watkins. 18 to shoot, Wolf top the key. Far corner now, Watkins. Holds out with both arms, shovels a feed to Scott. Free throw line area, walks it back. Torn half court, 7 on the shot clock, Scott. Running out of time, left elbow, trying to pull up, she will. Short, rebound, fought for, grabbed by EKU. And Freeman up ahead with a double dribble. Wow. It goes back to the RedHawks as Freeman double dribbled in transition on a sprint up the floor. The EKU fans hate the call. And the RedHawks gonna get it back here with 1:17 to go in the fourth, up by 6. Inbound to Wolf. Will be fouled by Racanati. It was tossed in on the inbound by Kloos, and then Racanati made contact with Wolf. She was trying to drive through the near side of the floor. You know, if Lacey come back in for EKU, Freeman's coming out. Miami's free throws at the line here, too, for Ivy Wolf.
RedHawks don't need too many more points, you think, to put the dagger in this one.
No. With 1:14 to go, first one is good. It makes it a 7-point RedHawk lead, so it's now a 3-possession game. Next one from Wolf. Couple dribbles, shoots it in for two. Free throws made at the line of the trip. Wolf will exit the game. So the RedHawks here will play defense. They're down, or they're up by eight. EKU down by eight. It's going to take the ball over the timeline here on the right wing. This is Racanati with it. Takes it far side in front of the EKU bench, around the arc, top the key with a ball here is Lacey. Right-handed dribble, flings up a prayer three, too far right, rebound, grabbed by the RedHawks, Watkins with it. Trouble down low, close, flings a pass, left wing Scott over the timeline, 50 seconds to go in the fourth. Scott escapes a defender, guns a pass, Morrow right side of the post. Top of the key it goes here for Watkins, back to the far side, Scott with the ball in front of the RedHawk bench. And a timeout called by Hendricks. Deanna Hendricks called the timeout as Scott kind of trapped up in front of the bench there on the far wing. EKU not fouling at all. We have 38.8 seconds to go in the fourth. RedHawks will inbound with 12 to shoot, and Miami up 72 to 64.
You surprised to see them not fouling?
I am. I think they should have.
Yeah, I think they should have too. Maybe just really dying to get back on the bus back home. I'm not sure.
And they will be back on a bus on Thursday to go to Northern Kentucky. The Colonels will. Then they're at Boston College on Tuesday, December 13th. That's an 11 a.m. game in Chestnut Hill on a Tuesday. And then they're going to be at Army the next Sunday. That's December 18th for a 1 o'clock start at West Point.
Wow, that's pretty tough. So they're in Massachusetts on Tuesday, and then they're in Albany, New York area the next 4 or 5 days later. It's a little bit of a tough schedule.
RedHawks to the ball here, far side of the timeout on the offensive end. Clues dishes back for Wolf, top the key, down low, the feed cut off there. It was intended for Scott, Racanati took it over, over the timeline on the right wing, Racanati, shot clock off, feeds it far wing, Rainey will try a three, short, with 18 seconds to go, Walker the offensive rebound, kicks it up for Collette, she's fouled. And Scott came in and made contact with her. Scott kind of leapt up there and landed on Collette in a weird way. And there's going to be the third personal on Scott. There will be free throws here for Collette of EKU. She will shoot two, I believe, with 14.7 seconds to go in this fourth quarter. Scott's going to exit the game. 23 minutes tonight for Scott, 13 points, 6 for 11 from the field. The first free throw good by Collette.
And it's really obvious. It doesn't take long watching this Miami women's basketball team to see how much of a leader Peyton Scott is out there on the floor. She just really always plays the game the right way, it seems like.
Seriously.
And, I mean, in addition to that intense intensity, she's so talented.
RedHawks lead by 6, 8 seconds to go in the game. They've got it far corner. Their offensive end, Cindy Watkins, was locked up there by a couple defenders, Freeman and Racanati. And Deanna Hendricks is going to call another timeout here to save her. Full timeout for the RedHawks. And they have no more timeouts remaining. So 7 seconds to go in the game. Miami 72, Eastern Kentucky 66. Looks like RedHawks going to pull this one out. It's a big win.
It was a big win, and it was a really fun game to watch. Ivy Wolf was excellent, as usual, her third straight 20-point game. And it was really fun to watch Peyton Scott get back out there and really get back on the horse. She played, 23 minutes tonight?
Yep.
13 points, 6 for 11 shooting. Really, really good night for both of those, guards.
Yeah, I think that's two really good storylines. Number one, RedHawk team that put together a really strong first half, you could say, an even stronger second half or beginning of it. A bad stretch here in this fourth quarter where EKU was able to make the game tighter. But number one, your team effort was really good tonight, and you got Scott going really close to 100%. Two great things to see tonight for this RedHawks team.
Yeah, and we mentioned it a couple times earlier. It kind of felt like Maddie Kloos really wasn't up to her normal self. Well, she still finished with a double-double, 12 points, 10 rebounds. Chipped in a couple assists and a couple steals, too.
Yeah.
So really, really nice team game for the RedHawks tonight.
So out of the timeout, RedHawks, again, have no timeouts left. 7 seconds even left in this fourth quarter of the game. Miami 72, Eastern Kentucky 66. Inbound for Miami, far corner of their offensive end to our right. Kloos will send it in off the leg of Rainey. It pops out of bounds. Rainey was right in on her defending. the old trick. Rainey's giving her no room.
I want to see her do the one that they did on Kobe one time where they pretended to throw right his face.
Yeah.
Be a good way to end this victory.
0.3 seconds came off, so 6.7 to go. Foul before the ball even went into play. Wolf knocked over Racanati. Distaste from the Millett Hall faithful for that one, and the ball is going back to EKU as they call Wolf for a charge. Scott, I think, is going to come back in here. Before that, EKU's called a timeout with 6.7 to go in the fourth. Down by six. I guess there's still a chance.
I guess, I don't know, maybe just these teams really don't want this game to end. It has been a really great game.
It's been fun, but... Well, that bust you a little warmer, I guess. Full timeout, too. Full timeout for Greg Todd's team in his second year with Eastern Kentucky. His former head coach at Moorhead State, also in the Bluegrass State for the last 7 years, where he made two WNIT appearances with the Eagles.
Pretty impressive stuff.
Moved on to EKU for his second year with the Colonels, or in the Atlantic Sun Conference.
Patrick, it's got to be a little weird for Eastern Kentucky. I was looking at their last few games. Last game they played at Tennessee, they lost 105-71 to the top 25 ranked Lady Vols, and the arena in that game had more than 8,000 people in it.
Seriously.
And tonight, I mean, what would you say? 250?
Yeah, that's about it. Yeah, 250, maybe less. That's a really good point.
Gotta be a little bit weird.
Yeah. So you have the inbound come here from the Colonels, looks like by their bench. And their offensive end of the floor on the far side. Emma Hacker will toss it in. 6.7 seconds to go. RedHawks leaders by six. It's gonna go out of bounds, or was there a foul call? It went down the far sideline.
Miami foul on one,
Matty Clouse. It's a foul on Clouse.
Penalty in effect.
You're going to have Rainey go to the line for EKU. I don't know, Clouse must have made contact there on the far side where the ball went in. 6.3 to go on the fourth. First free throw is good by Rainey at the line. 70% free throw shooter on the year. Second on the team coming into the night with 11 points per game on the season. Rainey will sink the second free throw. 16 points of the night for her tonight. RedHawks inbound at far side. Chambers is fouled immediately there by Hacker with 4.7 to go in the fourth. What is now a 4-point RedHawk lead. Still a 2-possession game. So I believe now if you put in a 2 free throws here, then it's pretty much a done deal.
Yeah.
Chambers to the line with Miami up 72-68, 4.7 to go in the fourth quarter, 4.7 seconds. Two bounces, the shot up too hard from Chambers, who is 4-for-6 from the line this season. Next one will be on the way here. Chambers resets her feet. Throws this one up. It's in. 73-68, the Red Hawk lead with 4.7 to go in this fourth quarter. You're going to have the Colonels in a 2-possession game. Put everybody up on their offensive end of the floor. The inbound's going to come from the baseline by Walker. It's going to take a miracle. Walker will fling this one all the way down the court for the baseline. Scott intercepts the pass, dribbles near half court, and there's your basketball game tonight. A very fitting end to this one. As Peyton Scott intercepts the long pass down the court by Walker to send this one to a victory for the RedHawks. Your final score tonight, 73-68, Miami winners over Eastern Kentucky. What a huge win for Miami on their home floor this evening.
It really was, and it really felt like these RedHawks got rolling on all cylinders for maybe one of the first times this year. They had a really good game last time out against Loyola Chicago. They were really good here tonight. Saw a lot of scoring from a lot of different people, and Peyton Scott and Ivy Wolf, probably the two stars of this team, yeah, both played really well here tonight.
Really well, RedHawk team that improves to 3-4 overall. Their opponent, Eastern Kentucky, falls to 4-4 this season. They're back to 500. You gotta be disappointed for a Colonel team that made it close, at least in the fourth quarter. The effort, though, comes up short, and it's gonna be kind of a long bus ride for Eastern Kentucky back home because they kind of had a chance in this game, just couldn't quite get to that point where they could make it really close.
Yeah, and they did a great job, honestly, coming back. It felt like this game was over a few different times, and then all of a sudden, Eastern Kentucky would be right back in it. Just couldn't quite get over that hump. RedHawks just played a little bit too good a defense down the stretch. I think Eastern Kentucky just couldn't quite make enough threes. If they had made a few more threes, obviously this game would have been a little bit closer. Good job by Miami, though, to play pretty nice complimentary basketball there down the stretch and close it out.
Right, it was pretty darn good. And RedHawks team, Jack, I think the big takeaway, number one, they were clicking tonight and a lot of points in this game. Really good to see number two, Peyton Scott, is back. Number three, when Peyton Scott is back on this team and Ivy Wolf plays well and Maddie Kloos plays well and some of these other players step up with these great efforts like we saw tonight, this team can make some noise.
Yeah, it really could, and we mentioned it. Peyton Scott really just brings a whole different aura to this team. They are kind of a young squad, but Peyton Scott is so experienced and she's just had so much success in her long Miami career so far. She just so intense out there, such a great fundamental basketball player,
yep,
and really fun to watch her out there tonight. She chipped in 5 steals too. I mean, that is seriously impressive stuff.
It really is. RedHawks shot 51% from the field tonight. EKU was 40%. A Miami team that put together some pretty good stuff here tonight. They turned the ball over though 24 times. Kind of want to bring that down a little bit, but
yeah, definitely. Win. Definitely going to want to clean that one up, yeah, a little bit there. RedHawks did out-rebound the Colonels pretty nicely, 42-27, so I guess that kind of makes up for it. But, yeah, definitely, Patrick, you're right. Going to want to take care of that ball a lot better going forward.
Right. All right, so we got a big men's game tomorrow. Cover starts 12:30 on RedHawk Radio. RedHawks take on Indiana State. A few storylines going into that one. Miami team that's trying to just pick themselves up after a tough start to the year. Really good Sycamore team going to come into Millett Hall tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, and it's really going to be an interesting litmus test for this Miami team. They've had a couple really nice games in a row against some not-so-great teams, so we'll be able to see how they do against a team that's already seen some serious success so far this year. I'm really excited to see if Billy Smith can continue his hot shooting ways, yeah, to see what Anderson Mirambo is able to do in the post, and Makai Larry, obviously, always going to be fun to watch here at
Millett
Hall.
Always. Dave Myers at our table, he wore a hockey shirt to a basketball game tonight.
Judging people on their outfits now?
I am.
I'm good.
All right. We thank Dave for all he does for our broadcast. He's an awesome guy. And Mike Wolf stopped by the table, too. So Mike, what are your thoughts on the game?
Wow. That was exciting. Yeah, I really am on the air.
You are.
Really?
Yeah.
That was your mistake.
Don't say anything too crazy.
Too crazy, yeah. Well, you can see what happens when those three starters get back in there much faster.
You did say that at halftime.
And they look at that big lead they took, and then the referees, the third team, almost gave it back. Don't you think?
Smart man.
That's what we thought.
Crazy calls out there.
Really crazy.
Crazy calls.
Crazy.
But you know who had a great game? Sierra Morrow. Did you notice how many points and rebounds she got? Lots of baskets inside. That's what we need.
Yep.
And your thought?
Pretty good game.
Huh?
Pretty good game.
Pretty
talked
good
about
game. Where are they now? 3-4?
RedHawks are 3-4.
Who do they play next?
They are on the road Sunday at Northern Kentucky.
Where?
Northern Kentucky. Kentucky. Yep.
Yeah, we'll wipe out the entire Commonwealth after this.
Yeah, they played Western a few games ago. Eastern. Is there a Southern Kentucky?
Eastern. We'll get rid of Northern. What's left? Southern?
I don't know if there is one.
I don't think they have a Southern Kentucky. They're that afraid of us.
If there is one, they better stay away from Millett Hall, that's for sure. If there is a Southern Kentucky, they better stay away from Millett Hall, that's for
really?
Sure. That's what I'm saying.
I didn't know they had a Southern
no,
Kentucky.
I'm saying if there is. I don't know if they do either.
Northern Kentucky.
I've never heard of them.
Northern, East, or West. All right. Tomorrow night, men's.
1 p.m. You excited?
1 p.m. And who are they playing?
Indiana State.
Indiana State. You know what they're famous for?
No.
No.
What?
You don't know. Do you know, Jack, what they're famous for?
I do know. They're seven.
Go ahead. No, go ahead. Yeah, they got a good record. Tell them what it's famous for.
Number 33, Larry Bird.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I knew that.
They played in the finals.
I knew that.
Against who?
Now that stumps me.
Michigan State.
Ah, Magic Johnson. Magic Johnson. I should have known that.
Yeah, you should have known that. You're fired.
What year was that?
What year was that? Somewhere about 1800.
you watched that. You were probably there.
Yeah, I was 50 years old then.
All right.
All right, what other stuff we got to talk about?
What do you want to talk about?
I've said it all.
All right. Well, you can come back tomorrow. We'll talk some more about that.
You're darn right we will.
All right.
And we're what, 3-4 in the men's?
I don't know. I got to look. I don't
we'll
know.
We'll be 4-4 tomorrow.
Okay. They're 3-1 at home.
Yeah, I think this team is about to hit its stride. I think they're starting to understand how each other plays. You really got basically seven new players out there with a new coach.
Yep.
And now the last couple of games, it looks like they're familiar with each other. They're showing they're quick and strong inside. It's going to be a good game.
I think so.
I agree. I mean, Travis Steele said it a couple games ago in his press conference. This is not high school basketball. All these guys are just really a few games removed from playing in the high school ranks.
Well, you got, Smith? He's
right.
A freshman. I'll tell you what, he's pretty good. Mabry, he's done well off the bench shooting those threes. But mostly Safford and Mirambo. Mm. Holy moly.
Fun to watch.
I think Mirambo's only 18 years old, and he has six more years of eligibility left in Miami.
Crazy.
Don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, and if I were a football coach, I'd try to squeeze an extra year out of him just to play tight end. How would you like to try to stop that coming over the
middle? I wouldn't want to at all. No, thank you.
He
no,
wouldn't
thank
even
you.
Need the pads.
No.
That's right.
If I was Ryan Day, I'd be here at Millett Hall looking at Anderson Mirambo. If I was Ryan Day, I'd be here at Millett Hall looking at Anderson Mirambo for my Ohio State football team.
Man.
Big, 320-pound, 6'8". And he moves like a ballerina. He moves like a bull, too, but I don't know. Bull wearing ballet shoes,
bull
maybe?
Bull in a tutu.
Yeah. Yeah. It's an interesting
image. He's
good. Yep. He's really good.
That guy's good.
Yep.
Of course, you know he's got that Cleveland State connection with the assistant coach. Did you know that?
Yep.
You did know that?
I did.
I'm glad you guys are paying attention. You
need
to be reading more and know what's going on with
your team.
Yeah.
I try.
Yeah, that's pretty good stuff. Yep. All right.
Anyone you want to say hi to?
No.
No?
Nobody that I know is listening. Is anybody listening?
Yeah. Handful of people.
Who?
We don't know.
Well, my mom. Probably.
My dad is.
She didn't get bored.
Dad?
Yep.
How close is your mom to this broadcast? I mean, is she tunes in all the time?
Yeah, she does. It's nice of her to.
Does she critique what you say?
She used to. She's kind of not so much anymore. Sometimes I think she just doesn't really listen.
She just gave up on you.
Yeah, exactly. That's what I think. She just turns it on in the background. And
she just wants some background noise.
Yeah,
and that's
exactly.
You, Jack, isn't it?
That works for me.
You know, whatever makes mom happy.
That's right.
And a Mother's Day is coming up.
It's always coming up.
Yeah, I know. It never ends. Does it? Yeah, as soon as you finish it, it's coming up again. All right, that's it. That's all I got to say. You can sign off now.
That's all we got, right?
That's all I got.
All right. See you tomorrow, 12:30 Eastern time. Red Hawks take on Indiana State. Luke West Pulley has a pregame for you. Tomorrow we got the call of that game from inside Millett Hall. For Mike Wolf, Jack Schmelzinger, Patrick Geshan, so long, good night from Millett Hall this evening. Red Hawks win at 73-68 over Eastern Kentucky. Thanks for tuning in tonight to this presentation of Miami basketball on Red Hawk Radio. Good night.
I love you.